Right now, South Africa is playing host to the global football elite. But the global IT elite are also on the continent in Ouagadougou, Burkina Faso. Their objective, preventing Africa from becoming the weakest link in the cybersecurity chain.
Africa has football fever. No matter which African team plays, the support is unanimous, like here in Ouagadougou, Burkina Faso. But among all the World Cup excitement, for a few days, this West African country shifted its focus to the critical issue of cybersecurity. Burkina Faso pulled out all the stops for the third ICT Best Practices Forum, which was attended by over 300 government and corporate leaders from 55 countries, discussing solutions to online threats to national security, infrastructure, or citizen services.
Microsoft's latest security intelligence report detected 126 million samples of malware in the second half of 2009 alone, an increase of 8.9% over the first half of the year. There is no doubt that cybercrime is a growing problem with the capacity to evolve into a global crisis if the correct approach is not taken to combat it.
The arsenal delegates discussed included increased collaboration, legislation, and education. As technology and broadband penetration continue to grow across Africa, so does the risk of cybercrime. Few countries here on the continent have an effective legal system in place to prosecute a crime that has no code of conduct, no protocol, no borders.
Cyber terrorists are believed to have infiltrated the computer.
The consequences could be catastrophic, with cyber terrorists infiltrating and targeting the computer systems that affect our daily lives, government offices, air traffic control systems, nuclear power plants, or dams. 2 years ago, a global response center was established in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Called IMPACT, it brings together the 190 member countries of the International Telecommunication Union, the world's oldest UN body, as well as law enforcement agencies like Interpol, the private sector, and academia. Attending the forum in Ouagadougou, its chairman said that cybersecurity generally does not rank high on the list among development priorities across Africa, an issue which needs to be addressed.
We also say to the rest of the world that you have to help Africa, because if you don't, the rest of the world is at risk from whatever that is going to come up to Africa, because the organized crime, the undesirable groups of the world is going to make use of this, what we call safe havens, to use as a launching base to threaten the rest of the world. And people who have extensive reliance on e-commerce, the developed countries, should particularly pay attention to help Africa, because otherwise it will be a threat to themselves.
Research from the US Cyber Consequence Unit shows that the destruction from a single wave of cyber attacks on America's critical infrastructures could exceed $700 billion, the equivalent of 50 major hurricanes hitting US soil at once. Already, costs of cyber fraud exceed $1 trillion a year.
As a company, we have our intelligence data that tells us the kind of attacks that are happening. And as a major software company, we make sure that we stay on top of the things that are happening in the cyber criminals world, so that we can actually find a patch or a defense against all of that.
La vision de la CEDEAO.
But not all companies and governments share the gravity of the issue. Hamadoun Toure, Secretary General of the ITU, said it is high time for the world to get engaged to develop effective cybersecurity programs and policies.
In the cybersecurity, we are always as strong as the weakest link. We are in a connected world, and the criminal AR can be anywhere. We need to be organized. We need to make sure that every country put in place a national legal and regulatory framework so that we can criminalize crime.
President of host nation Burkina Faso compared the importance of tackling cybercrime with the issue of nuclear disarmament.
We need partnerships to provide a framework to have a more effective way to control cybercrime. The next step should be an international summit where concrete measures are decided to address cybercrime.
Notre souhait c'est que nous allions effectivement vers une conférence internationale qui,
as has been done for other critical issues like disarmament of weapons of mass destruction and nuclear arms.
Once the World Cup is over, it'll be back to business as usual. But the message from Ouagadougou was clear. Cybersecurity cannot be ignored any longer. A global concern, it requires a global response.